A very good morning to everyone. Welcome to class 11th economics. Till yesterday, we had already completed the chapter theory of demand. Theory of demand, that is, we did about what is demand, what are the different exceptions to law of demand, again, law of demand. Then different types of goods, factors affecting demand of commodity, individual demand and its factors, market demand, its diagram, its schedule, everything we have already covered. Now, we are starting a new chapter now, that is price elasticity of demand. Price elasticity of demand. Let me discuss it with the whiteboard. See, first of all, the topic which we are taking now is price elasticity of demand. बेटे ध्यान से समझना है आपको. Here, first of all, you should know the meaning of elasticity, that what is meant by elasticity. You can write down in a notebook too. Elasticity here means changeability. Elasticity here means changeability. That means changeability of demand. Ki demand kitna change ho rahi hai. Changeability of demand. So when we have to define what is price elasticity of demand, which means I have to mention due to change in price, what is the resultant change in demand? This is called price elasticity of demand. I repeat, due to change in price of a commodity, what is the resultant change in demand? This is known as price elasticity of demand. ठीक है. तो सर, how we will define this price elasticity of demand? We will simply define it that price elasticity of demand refers to the change in demand or the degree of responsiveness of demand due to change in its price. समझे आप लोग? Price में change होने से, due to change in price, what is the resultant change in demand? Demand mein change kya aaya? This is called price elasticity of demand. Is this clear to everyone? The definition is clear that what is the change in demand due to change in price of the commodity. Suppose earlier the price of tomato in the market was 80 rupees per kg and you were buying 2 kg tomatoes per week. But now when the price of tomato has increased to 100 rupees per kg, the question arises, how much change in demand is now taking place? This will be known as price elasticity of demand. Clear? So sir, please tell us, what is the difference between law of demand and what is the difference between elasticity of demand? Are both are the different concept. How? Dekhe, law of demand shows us the direction of change. Law of demand kya show karta hai? It shows the direction of change. Price rises, demand falls. Price falls, demand rises. So law of demand is showing direction of change, that when price will rise, the demand will fall. When the price will fall, the demand will rise. That is direction of change. But elasticity of demand shows us the degree of change. The elasticity of demand shows us the degree of change, that if price rises by 20%, then what will be the resultant fall in demand? वो हमें वो बताएगा. तो ध्यान रखना है. लॉ ऑफ डिमांड डायरेक्शनल चेंज बताता है, लेकिन इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड डिग्री चेंज बताता है. ठीक, लॉ ऑफ डिमांड हमें बताता है दैट इट विल इंक्रीज और इट विल डिक्रीज एज पर द चेंज इन प्राइस. बट व्हाट इज बीइंग टोल्ड बाय द इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड, इट टेल्स अस अबाउट व्हाट विल बी द डिग्री ऑफ चेंज. डिग्री ऑफ चेंज का मतलब है हाउ मच चेंज विल टेक प्लेस, whether 20%, whether 10%, whether 50%, whether 100%, that is elasticity of demand. ठीक, okay. तो देखते हैं जरा what is the definition of elasticity of demand. See, price elasticity of demand refers to degree of responsiveness. Just underline this, please. You can write side by side. I am even underlining the important concepts. It refers to degree of responsiveness. Degree of responsiveness का देखिए यहाँ क्या मतलब है. Degree of responsiveness मतलब कितने degree से उसने respond किया of demand of a commodity to a change in its price. To a change in its price. किसी भी commodity के price में change होने की वजह से डिमांड ने कितने डिग्री से रेस्पॉन्ड किया, दैट इज नोन एज प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. आई रिपीट वंस अगेन, विद द चेंज इन प्राइस, प्राइस में चेंज होने की वजह से डिमांड ने कितने डिग्री से रेस्पॉन्स किया, दैट इज नोन एज प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. ऑल राइट, इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन दैट व्हाट इज प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड? Means अगर market के अंदर a commodity's price has changed by any percentage, then what is the resultant change in its demand? उसकी demand में कितना change हुआ? This is known as price elasticity of demand. Clear? That means elasticity tells us how much do consumer react. Simple. Elasticity हमें बताता है कि consumer कितना से react करेगा. देखो जो अभी मैंने circle किया. Elasticity tells us how much do consumer react. Consumer कितने से react करेगा? अच्छा, consumer कैसे react कर सकता? Can you people tell me please? How can react a consumer? Suppose with a 50% change in the price of air conditioner, AC का price 50% से increase हुआ. How can a consumer react? Consumer कैसे react कर सकता है उस चीज के अंदर? With a 50% change in the price of air conditioner, Ayush said demand will get low. Of course, Ayush, demand will be lower. That we already know. But what will be the degree? What can be the various alternatives of degrees? That I just want to know. Okay, I just tell you about the degrees. Dhyan se sunna beta. Please listen to me very carefully. And side by side, start noting down my points, what I'm speaking in your notebook, because these are very, very important and golden words for you people for this concept. Whenever there is a change in price of air conditioner, let's suppose by 50%, the demand may react in following ways. You will agree or not? Aap saath saath mujhe har point ke baad likh ke batayenge. You agree in this or not? Okay? First point. Suppose price of air conditioner increases by 50%. The demand may react as change in demand also will take as 50%, which means demand will fall by 50%. Agree or not? That can happen. That can be the response of demand. Of course. Take care. Second alternative, the demand may react by less than 50%. The demand may react by less than 50%. Means agar AC ke price mein 50% se increase hui hai demand, price increase hua 50% ka, to demand ho sakta hai 50% se kam se decrease ho. Ye bhi demand ka reaction ho sakta hai. Bilkul ho sakta hai. Agreed. Very good. Third option ho sakta hai. The demand may react by more than 50%. Yani ki price kam, price bada 50% se, तो डिमांड 50% से ज्यादा एकदम कम हो गई. यस, दैट कैन बी आल्सो वन ऑफ द अल्टरनेटिव. ये भी एक अल्टरनेटिव हो सकता है. थर्ड ऑल्टरनेटिव ये हो गया, अग्रीड। फोर्थ ऑल्टरनेटिव, जब प्राइस बढ़ा कूलर का या एसी का 50% से, द डिमांड डिड नॉट चेंज। लोगों को चाहिए चाहिए था, लोगों की हैबिट में था, लोगों की नेसेसिटी में था वो प्रोडक्ट, डिमांड चेंज ही नहीं हुई, लोगों ने फिर भी खरीदा। दैट कैन बी द फोर्थ रिएक्शन, है ना, ये फोर्थ रिएक्शन हो सकता है डिमांड का। फिफ्थ रिएक्शन क्या हो सकता है, आप मुझे बताइए फिफ्थ रिएक्शन क्या हो सकता है। हमने चार रिएक्शंस पढ़ लिए, डिमांड जीरो से चेंज हुई, डिमांड सेम चेंज हुई मतलब वन से चेंज हुई, डिमांड वन से ज्यादा चेंज हुई, डिमांड वन से कम चेंज हुई। फिफ्थ क्या हो सकता है, जो हमने जीरो बोला, फोर्थ वाला डिमांड चेंज ही नहीं हुई वो हमने बोल दिया। फिफ्थ क्या हो सकता है, डिमांड इनफाइनाइटली चेंज हो गई, देयर इज इनफाइनाइट चेंज इन डिमांड, देयर इज इनफाइनाइट चेंज इन डिमांड। दैट मींस व्हाट कैन बी द डिफरेंट रिएक्शंस ऑफ डिमांड विद द चेंज इन price of the commodity, elasticity. Let me tell you about the first point. What can be the first change? Elasticity of demand is equals to one. Okay, this is the first change. Please write down. Elasticity of demand is equals to one. What do you mean by here equals to one? Equals to one means whatever change takes place in price, the same change is taking place in demand. Suppose if the price of the commodity has increased by 20%, so there is decrease in demand also by 20%. Same change hua. Usko bolte hain equal to one, unity. This is called unity. किसको बोलते हैं हम लोग बेटे, यूनिटी, ठीक है, इट इज इक्वल्स टू यूनिटी, इज इट क्लियर? ओके, सेकंड रिएक्शन क्या हो सकता है, रेस्पॉन्स क्या हो सकता है डिमांड का, प्लीज राइट इन द चैट बॉक्स एंड लेट मी नो व्हाट कैन बी द सेकंड रिएक्शन ऑफ डिमांड। इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज व्हाट आई शुड राइट, प्लीज राइट इन द चैट बॉक्स, आई एम गेटिंग द आंसर्स। ओके ओके ओके, मोर देन वन, सेकेंड ले लेते हैं, मोर देन वन। मोर देन वन मीन्स इफ प्राइस चेंजेस बाय 20%, तो डिमांड विल चेंज बाय मोर देन 20%, डिमांड विल चेंज बाय मोर देन 20%, सो दैट इज नोन एज मोर देन यूनिटरी इलास्टिक, या हम भी लिख देते हैं मोर देन यूनिटी। All right, okay sir. Sir, third बताओ, ठीक है बेटे, third बताते हैं आपको। What can be the third response or third reaction of demand due to change in price? Elasticity of demand is less than one. It's less than one, or we can call it less than unity. Which means if the price of the commodity changes by 20%, the demand will change by less than 20%. Demand less than 20% se change hogi. That is known as less than unity. Usko hum log bolte hain less than unitary elastic demand. Theek? Achha sir, sir batao fourth kya hoga? Bete fourth maine aapko bataya tha zero le lo. Zero matlab demand ka reaction zero aaya. प्राइस चेंज हुआ 20% से, लेकिन डिमांड में कोई चेंज नहीं हुआ, डिमांड ने जीरो से चेंज किया, क्या जीरो का मतलब थोड़ा बहुत चेंज भी होता है? नो, नॉट एट ऑल, जीरो का मतलब बिल्कुल भी चेंज नहीं हुआ। तो सर उसको नाम क्या बोले हम, नाम दे सकते हैं हम, इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज परफेक्टली इन इलास्टिक, परफेक्टली इन इलास्टिक। परफेक्टली इन इलास्टिक का मतलब है बिल्कुल भी चेंज ना होना। मैंने आपको देखो इलास्टिसिटी का मतलब बताया था चेंज होना, तो मुझे बताओ इन इलास्टिक का क्या मतलब होगा, इन इलास्टिक का मतलब होगा बिल्कुल भी चेंज ना होना। सो इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज परफेक्टली इन इलास्टिक, व्हाट वी कैन कॉल इट, we can call it elasticity is zero. Elasticity zero है, इसका मतलब ये है कि elasticity क्या है, zero है. अच्छा सर, तो सर fifth बताइए. चलो बेटे आपको fifth बताते हैं. Fifth and the last response of demand. You people tell me in the chat box what will be the last response of demand. Ashima, please listen to me here. Ashima, you should hear to me. Class is going on. So what would be the fifth change in the elasticity? Elasticity of demand will be kitna? Perfectly elastic का मतलब है elasticity is infinity, मतलब the demand change infinitely. So ultimately we can clearly say that price elasticity of demand is the change in demand that takes place due to change in its price. प्राइस में चेंज होने की वजह से डिमांड में जो चेंजेस आ रहे हैं उसको हम लोग बोलते हैं प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. एंड चेंजेस फाइव टाइप्स के होते हैं. द चेंजेस टेक्स प्लेस इन फाइव वेज, इन फाइव टाइप्स. इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इक्वल्स टू वन, इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड मोर देन वन, लेस देन वन, इक्वल्स टू जीरो एंड इक्वल्स टू इन्फिनिटी. All right. अच्छा सर, तो जरा देखते हैं इनके बारे में कौन कौन से कैसे कैसे चेंजेस होते हैं. लेट्स स्टडी वंस अगेन, वंस वन बाय वन ईच पॉइंट. जस्ट हैव अ लुक. सी, प्लीज नोट डाउन दिस नेम्स. डिग्रीज ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. द प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड मे चेंज इट बाय. नाउ यू पीपल हैव टू टेल मी विच वन इज इक्वल्स टू वन, विच वन इज मोर देन वन, which one is less than one, which one is infinity and which one is zero. You have to tell me please. You people tell me that which we are talking about. Now tell me, perfectly inelastic. First of all, I talk about perfectly inelastic. Bataiye mujhe perfectly inelastic kaun sa hoga bete. I'm talking about this one, perfectly inelastic. कौन सा होगा बेटे ये perfectly inelastic? It will be ED is equals to, क्या बोलते हैं हम, inelastic पूरी तरह zero. All right, so perfectly inelastic is ED equals to zero. अच्छा, इसके बाद perfectly elastic बताइए पहले मुझे. Perfectly elastic, ED will be equals to perfectly elastic. Very good. ED equals to infinity. I don't get the sign of infinity here, so I'll just write here infinity. All right, wonderful. Tell me, unitary elastic. This is unitary elastic. ED will be equals to unitary elastic means it is talking about one, proper one. So here ED is equals to one. Very good, bete. Relatively elastic. कहीं ना कहीं ज़्यादा elastic है. इसका मतलब ये है. तो relatively elastic will be equals to ED will be equals to, very good everyone, more than one, which means we can say ED greater than one. Very good everyone. So relatively inelastic. Relatively elastic means kahin na kahin it is inelastic. So here ED would be less than one. So it is less than one. I hope this is clear to all. ED equals to zero, ED equals to one, ED more than one, ED less than one, ED equals to infinity. So these are the different degrees or different types of elasticities of demand. Ye different degrees hain bete elasticity of demand ke. Is it clear to everyone? Any doubt is there? Moving on to the next. Fine. Now let us talk about the first, perfectly elastic demand. Usse bhi pehle we just go for unitary elastic demand. See how we are going to make the unitary elastic demand curve and how we are going to define it. Let us see. Bete, please make the heading in the notebook. unitary elastic demand. Make the heading in the notebook, please. Unitary elastic demand. Make the heading, please. Unitary elastic demand. Now, how we are going to define that? What is unitary elastic demand? I told you, whatever is the change in price, the demand also changes with the same percentage. For example, if there is change in price by 20%, then demand also changes by 20%. This is known as unitary elastic demand. This is known as unitary elastic demand, which means when we define that percentage change in demand is 20%, then percentage change in price is also 20%. So whenever the percentage change in price and the percentage change in demand are equal, this is known as unitary elastic demand. All right. So how we define unitary elastic demand? We simply define it as the percentage change in price is equals to the percentage change in quantity demanded. So how we are going to make the diagram? I'm just making its diagram on whiteboard so that you can easily come to know about how to make it. See, first of all, we are making the y-axis, and this is the x-axis. So this is the x-axis. And this is your y-axis. All right. What we are taking on the x-axis? Quantity demanded. And what we are taking on the y-axis? We are taking on the y-axis price. Those who have switched off their cameras, I have marked absent for them. Those who are switching off the camera in between. So what? How I have to make this? See, I told you unitary elastic demand, which means suppose earlier price was 100, yahan dhyan rakhna. If earlier price was 100, demand was also 100. So this was the curve earlier. When price was 100, demand was also 100. So that was the state earlier. Now, when price comes to 80, price kam hua 80, dekha ro kitna gap kam hua. Mujhe batao, with the reduction in price, what will be the effect on the demand? Demand will fall or demand will rise? Pehle to aap ye bataiye, fatafat write in the chat box. With the reduction in price, there will be rise in the demand, which means the curve would be like this. But make sure jitna gap change ka aapne price mein liya bete, utna hi gap aapne change ka demand mein lena hai. Kyun? Kyunki price jitne se kam hua, demand utne se hi reduce hui hai. Kaise? Ek bar main aapko aur likh deta hu. See, जैसे suppose ये हमने यहाँ पे show कर दिया, price कम हुआ, आप देख रहे हो demand बढ़ गई, price was reduced here by 20% and बेटे यहाँ पे demand also increased by 20%. Thik? So this is the unitary elastic demand. How I am going to make the curve? Bete, this is the curve. Wait. This is the curve. Of course, downward sloping curve, left to right downward sloping, but making a unity. It is making a unity. Why it is making a unity? Because the reduction in price is equals to increment in demand. As the percentage in price reduced by 20%, the demand also increased by the 20%. This is known as unitary elastic demand. Is it clear to everyone? Is this diagram clear to everyone that how unitary elastic demand is made? If any doubt is there, you can write in the chat box. Acha, what is the nature of this demand curve? This demand curve is left to right downward sloping curve. Simple, this demand curve is left to right downward sloping curve, making a horizontal we can say making, it's making a rectangular hyperbola. It's making a rectangular hyperbola, which means what is the nature of this demand curve? This demand curve makes a rectangular hyperbola. Rectangular hyperbola means on the demand curve, wherever you point out, aap kisi bhi point pe, agar aap mark karte ho, let me mark it. Any point if you mark here, ek minute ruko. See, if you mark here at any point, ye jo main jaise yellow yellow se mark kar raha hu, kisi bhi point pe bete aap mark karte ho, to what you will observe, ki iska aur iska jo distance hoga na, wo hamesha barabar hoga. Ye distance hamesha equal hoga is distance ke. So that distance will be always equal to yani ki at any yellow point you will see that the distance from any of the point to both the axes is same. That is known as rectangular hyperbola. That is known as rectangular हाइपरबोला. उसको हम लोग बोलते हैं रेक्टेंगुलर हाइपरबोला. इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीवन? सो दिस वाज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट दैट हाउ यूनिटरी इलास्टिक डिमांड कर्व इज मेड.